Timing your code is really important. You can simply do that out of curiosity or maybe because you want to find the fastest version of your code. In today's video, you're going to learn how to do that using the module Timeit. All right, as usual, I'm going to import a few things. Timeit. Time. All right. So inside the Timeit module, there is a class, which is Timer. And this class is actually what we're going to use. However, we're not going to use the constructor directly because the module provides convenience functions that create that for us. All right. So the first function we're going to use is Timeit. So I'm going to print the result of Timeit, which is the module, Timeit, which is the function. So we need to pass a few arguments for it to work. So the first argument is statement. Right, then the second argument is setup, the third argument is timer, the fourth argument is number, one, and the last argument is globals. All right. So actually, I've just used empty strings, but it's not the right thing to do. It was just to show all the arguments, and now I'm going to actually explain to you what each argument is. So the statement is actually the code that we want to time. Then setup is the code that we want to execute before the actual statement, and it's not going to be timed. So if you want to, for example, I don't know, import something or assign something to a variable, etc., before running the code, you have to do that in the setup. Timer is actually the timer to use. The default one is this one, time.perfCounter. This actually uses the wall clock. Basically, if you have something else going on in the computer that slows everything down, this is going to increase the time needed to execute the statement. I hope that makes sense. And you could use time.processTime as timer to actually get only the time used by the process, which means your script, all right? And not the time that it had to wait because of other things going on. So let's say that you wait for 2 seconds because you use time.sleep2. PerfCounter would count that and processTime wouldn't count that. Then you've got number, okay? Number is the number of times the statement is going to be repeated. So basically, Timeit is going to run the code the number of times that you entered, all right? And then it's going to return the total time taken. And then globals, actually the default one is none. So globals specifies a namespace which the code is going to execute in. So by default, the code is executed within Timeit's namespace. So if you define a function in here, this is not going to be available inside of the Timeit namespace. So we're going to have a look at how you can do that later on. So it's time to see everything in action. I'm going to copy that and paste it here. So our first statement is going to be x equal 0. Setup nothing. We don't need to pass timer because this is actually the default one. Gonna run it 1 million times, and then we don't need to pass this either. All right, so we are actually doing this 1 million times and see how long it takes. Then I'm going to copy this and paste it. Our second statement is going to be while x less than million, x plus equal 1. Setup, we can just do x equal 0, and we just want this to run once, all right, because we are already looping 1 million times, so you don't want 2 million, 3 million, etc. We are actually increasing the variable, and we are setting the variable equal to 0 before we run this. So this is how you can use setup. We can actually have a look at the difference between the while loop and the for loop. So we could do something like range 1 million plus, because here we don't want to do anything, because here we need to increase the variable. Here you don't need to increase the variable. Set up nothing, and then once. Perfect. I'm actually going to save the file and see what we actually get. All right, so terminal, new terminal, then Python time execution. Let's see. As you can see, 17 milliseconds, 69 milliseconds, and 23 milliseconds. As you can see, the for loop is so much faster. I mean, so much faster. It's faster than the while loop. So if you need to repeat things over and over, the for loop is better. We could actually run it again and see. Yeah, as you can see, it's still the same. So you've got that. Perfect. Let me clear terminal. Perfect. By the way, you can actually separate lines of code inside the statement or setup with the semicolon. So for example, let's say we want to do something like this. Y equal 0. And then we can do something like, I don't know, copy this and do something like here, y equals 0, and then you want to add 1 to y as well. So this is actually going to work. The only thing that you need to keep in mind is that here, the y plus equal 1 is actually part of the while loop. So inside the while loop block, there's x plus equal 1 and y plus equal 1. Okay, so these are indented in the same way. Perfect. Let's try to run that. All right. As you can see, everything is working just fine. Perfect. Let's clear this up. So this actually works. All right. But if I had a long piece of code to test, I would put it all into a function and then call the function. Okay, I'll show you how you can do that in a minute. So we've had a look at Timeit, but there is another function that is used when you want to call Timeit multiple times. Instead of doing something like this, for example, let's say that you want to actually repeat that 5 times. Let's comment this out. So here you want to run this 5 times and then get, you know, different results, and then you can actually get the best one, etc., etc. You could do this, and we can actually run this. Right? As you can see, you get different results. But the best way of doing that is actually using repeat. So instead of doing this, time it dot repeat, all right, and then you get the statement. Actually going to copy this bit, do that, then you've got the setup still the same, and then repeat another argument, and I'm going to repeat it 6 times. 5 is actually the default one. I'm just going to use 6. Perfect. So repeat is going to return a list of times, okay, one for each time it call. So basically it's going to do this, you know, this thing for 6 times. So let's say that here you've got 10, it would be 60, because 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, etc. 6 times, 60 times, 60 times this. But 10 times for each time it, right? So it would be like the first time would be 10 times this, and then the time, and then again 10 times this, and then the time, etc., etc. Let's actually run this so you can see. I'm gonna save the file, and then run Python. All right. So as you can see, you've got a list of all the results, which is the same as this. Usually the lowest value is the one that shows how fast your machine can run the given statement. Higher values are not typically caused by variability in Python speed, but by other things running on your machine. The lowest value is the one you should be interested in. All right, so for example, in this case, we've got this. So this is actually the sort of best time. This could be this high because actually there was another process running that slowed everything down. So earlier I was saying that the code is executed in the Timeit's namespace, but what if I want to test functions or other things that we defined inside a script's namespace? Let's actually have a look at that. I'm gonna comment this out like that. So let's say we've got this function, which is my function. I'm actually going to do this pass. So if we tried to actually do something like this, so let's get this like that, and we wanted to do something like call my function here. This wouldn't work, okay, because it would say my function is not defined. Why? Because inside Timeit's namespace, there is not my function. It's not defined there. So to actually call the function, there are two ways you can use. The first one is by importing the things we need in the setup. So you could do something like from main, which is this file, import my function. Be careful, you don't need to do something like that. You just need to do something like that, okay? Because you don't actually want to call the function while you're importing it. You want to call it later, all right? This is actually a good way of testing, you know, long pieces of code. So here you could have lots of code and you could test it simply like that instead of having to put everything into this string. Let's actually try that out. So I'm actually going to clear the terminal, run Python. All right, as you can see, everything is still working. Perfect. Then the second way is by passing globals. So globals is actually a built-in function that returns the dictionary of the current global symbol table, which actually contains all the information needed by the program, like methods, variable names, etc. Okay. And by passing globals to globals, all right, we're going to cause the code to be executed in a global namespace. And therefore, we are going to be able to access all the functions defined in there, etc., etc. All right. So you don't need to import them. And this is actually the best way of doing that, at least in my opinion. So let's have a look. So we've got that. That. So we're still calling my function here, but we don't need to do that anymore. We just need to do something like globals equal globals. Perfect. Let's actually run this. We're gonna get the same result as before. So Python. All right, as you can see, this is still working. Perfect. This is basically how you time your code. I'm going to actually close everything. All right. And that's it.